That's good now. So guys, welcome back to my channel. It's today the video you asked me on Instagram for. It's my moving to Norway video. I made an Instagram story where you could ask me some questions about my moving to Norway, and yeah, there was a lot of questions. I didn't expect that, so I asked for a video and you said yeah, do it. So I'm doing it now. On my MacBook I have some questions, and yes, so I will read them and answer them. Yay! Okay. Why? Why now? You could have done that the whole day. Why? Start. Aye. Okay, so the first question is, where are you going to move? As I said, I'm going to move to Norway, and I'm moving on the 1st of November this year. I didn't expect it so early. I thought I could move to Norway earliest in 2 years or something, because I started study working thing here in Germany in August, but I realized Germany is not my country. I want to live for forever. It's like I lost my heart in Norway, and my whole body wants to go back. And it's like, when I watch the videos or my Snapchat memories or stuff like that, then I really get sad. So I was like, okay, you have to do something now. It's not working out like that. So you're young, you have the opportunity to go. So why aren't you going, Sissy? And when Sissy has something in her head, she has to do it. That's like, it's typical of me. So next question is, what to do in Norway? Yes, I'm going to study in Norway next year in the autumn semester. And it's called veterinary nursing. It's something like, after that you can work in a horse clinic in the pharmaceutical or in laboratories and like everywhere in the clinic with animals. I would like to do it with horses in a horse clinic or something. We will see. But yeah, I think it's very interesting. I worked in a horse clinic here in Germany for 2.5 months now. Oh no, 2 months? Yeah. So I realized, yeah, that's my thing. I want to do it, but not in Germany. I'm not happy here. It's not what I want. So yeah, I will do it in Norway. Now, next question. Why Norway? Yeah. I don't know. When it was the first time in Norway, beginning this year, I completely lost my heart there. The people, the country, it's like everything was so nice, and I don't know, I lost my heart there. Norway is so beautiful, the landscapes are so beautiful. It's a land, it's very like technical, forward and stuff. It's, yeah, they are a bit more forward than Germany, and also the humans. The people who are living there, they are always so nice, they're friendly, they are in a nice mood. Sure, not everyone, but all the people I know or I see, and it's like, I don't know. You have to go to Norway and make your own view. Have your own view. And trust me, it's your own risk to go to Norway, because if you go, you maybe not coming back. No, but yeah. That's why Norway, the people, the land, the country, everything. It's perfect for me, I think. And if not, I can come back every time. So yeah. People make mistakes. It's not like, this is my last chance to do something, or you know, I can always come back again. I can do whatever I want. That's good that we're living in this time of the century. I can do whatever I want. Yeah, what will you miss in Norway? I think I will miss the prices. Because Norway is a very expensive country, but you're earning much money, so more money than in Germany, so it's like it comes together, but yeah, it's still expensive. Yeah, this is a bit like but yeah, I can live with it, and I have to eat healthy then, because the healthy stuff is not so expensive. Yeah, no, and hello, I will miss Kinder chocolate and Nutella. Sure, they have it there, but it's like the maxi pack you can get there is like 6 Kinder chocolates. In Germany you can get like 20 or maybe more, huh? Yeah. What will I miss? Yeah, my friends, of course, friends and family, but it's, yeah, I will visit them or they can visit me, so this is not so bad, and I can be in contact with them every day, like with social media. Yeah, so I think this is not so bad, and I think it's a good chance to see who my real friends are. Yeah, what will I pack was the question. Yeah, I will pack winter stuff, sure. Lots of pullovers, ski underwear, and yeah, riding clothes. Yeah, so warm and big clothes. And it's raining now. Huh? Okay, where's the rainbow? Yeah. Raining jackets. No, like, yeah, stuff like that, because the winter is very cold. I think, but it's a nice cold, kind of. In Germany here it's cold, no snow, at my place, no snow. It's like only this muddy something, everything is gray, and it's not feeling really winter, it's like an ugly whatever it is. And yeah, in a way, it's like 3 meter snow or something, and I'm really excited to see that, because I've never seen it before in my life. Maybe I will learn to ski or driving snowboard, I don't know. Yeah. And next question. When are you coming back? I am coming back first time in end of December over New Year's, and then I'm going back on the 3rd of January maybe. Yeah, to get some more stuff with me, and yeah, because I can't bring everything at the first time, and yeah, no, that's too expensive. Yeah. Then how do I get to Norway? I could drive with the car, but I'm not bringing my car with me. If you could travel with the car, it's like to Sandefjord, it's like 9 hours, I think, but nah. I don't want to drive 9 hours, and I'm taking the plane, so the flight is going from Amsterdam to Sandefjord, and it's not so expensive and very cheap actually, and it's only 1 hour and 50 minutes, so yeah. And with the train from Osnabrück to Amsterdam, it's like 3 hours, maybe 3 hours, I think. And it's also not expensive, so I could drive with the train. I can drive with the train in the airport in Amsterdam, so yeah, that's very easy. The next question is if I found a boyfriend there and that's why I want to go there. No, it has nothing to do with boys. Next question. What did your parents say? Yeah. First I told my mom and my best friend, and they were like, okay, yeah, it's a bit sad, but if it's the best for you, if you think that's the best for you, you should do it. The difficult one was my father, because I thought he wouldn't be so happy about it, that I want to move to Norway alone, and oh, Norway is an expensive country, and what does it cost and everything. But I made a whole like presentation on my MacBook for him to show him and list everything positive of Norway and positive what it's like positive for me. And that's also the next question, what's coming. And to study in Norway, it's not expensive. Sure, it depends on which university you're going, but what is it in English? So you have to pay every semester something. So that's completely normal, I think, everywhere. And in Germany here, it's like 300 euros maybe, and in Norway it's just 30 or 60 euros per semester you pay, so that's kind of nothing, because Norway, the country said, should be able to learn something and to do what they want. And so yeah, to live there, the university and the study rooms, I don't know the English word, but you know what I mean. So that's also not so expensive. I think it's kind of the same than in Germany. So it depends where you study. Sure, and also in the capital city, everything is very expensive. That's clear. But where I want to go to study is not so expensive. So yeah, and I maybe share a room with Sinoor or and Andrea. Yeah. So that's also, I'm very excited for this. Yeah, that's also the payment question. Yeah, guys, so I think that was it with this video. I think that was so the most important questions. Yeah, I think they're clear now, and if you have more questions or maybe want to do the same, I don't know, let me know. Yeah, but I think that was it. So cool from you that you listen to me. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a like. Yeah, this is very important. Yeah. So yeah, see you in the next video.